Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Dear students, our today's topic is very dear to heart. Muhammad, the last messenger of God. Muhammad, peace be upon him. So, as we know that the best code of conduct belongs to Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. And we know that he is prophet of all mankind, rather prophet of all worlds, mercy for all worlds. And today in these slides, we are gonna discuss briefly characteristics and his life and gonna derive lessons from those. I have with me Sister Shabano. She would be participating in the discussion. Sister Shabano, over to you.
Assalamu alaikum. A very beautiful, literally very close to heart. And it's always to go through his life, his seerah. So it's very overwhelming for me and for all of us that you're again going into the study. So I hope we should start.
Jazakallah. Should I start from the first slide, which is second slide actually?
Yeah.
Jazakallah. Okay. A warm welcome to you to help you get a glimpse of the noble messenger of Allah and benefit through his model personality, practical teachings, exemplary life, and the proven formula that we provide you peace, success, and salvation. So now these are few lessons which we would be deriving from these this study or group discussion, because he is the best example in all these areas, right? We'll move to next and then we'll continue the discussion. So he was savior and liberator. How? So we will just discuss this briefly, but I would read through that. What were times feel like or how they used to be when Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was not born? And after him, when he declared the prophecy, what happened? True concept of God was lost. It was the time before Muhammad, peace be upon him. True concepts of God lost, ignorance and darkness, barbarism and ruthlessness, sexual slavery, nudity, and persecution of women, usury and exploitation, fear and terror, class and color discrimination. Times after Muhammad, peace be upon him. True concept of God restored, knowledge and light, kindness and mercy, woman's status and rights, justice and fairness, peace and security, love and brotherhood. The both slides are showing the difference. Sister Shabano, please comment on this.
Yeah, I must say the slides are very much precisely prepared. And this is a quick overview of what was happening before Muhammad ﷺ's appearance in the earth or in that society. It was not like that they were not aware of the God, the concept of God, but it was deteriorated. It was not like that they were not offering prayer or having not fast or going for the Hajj. Everything was there, but the spirit was gone. There were many new things were added that have nothing to do with the spirit of the concept of God. So there was a vast difference. There was a vast difference already created by the followers. This difference and this distance created anarchy in the society. There were fights, tribal fights all over there. There was no peace at all. Women were treated very badly. Even they were not welcomed anywhere, and they were not having rights as a human being. They were not given the rights as a human being. So we can feel, and we all have must have read, all the students must have gone through the period of what was the situation over there. And then there is a total new face of the society, and that was after when he explored himself, and then he like explained everything through his practical knowledge, through his practical implication of God's fear and God's realization. I believe it is a total twist, you know. All those who were always into fight, even for water, they were now ready to sacrifice their whole thing, whole life, including all the material things. So it was a total shift. So there is a question mark, how, what was the reason behind it? Only one person. Just look at the scenario, that there were tribes and there were fights and there was anarchy, there was chaos, and there was only one person. Here I want to give a takeaway, and this is my takeaway, that if even you are a one person and you're right and you're having a belief on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you are faithful, if you are fearful, you are a true believer, then Allah ta'ala will gather the whole support system in the form of companion, as we know. So Allah subhanahu, it shows that this twist shows that we need only one person. And if I can be that person, the change can be here as well. So I think we go, and anything else, Vishwa Saman, you want to add?
No, you said it all. The slide said it all, and you said it all, Jazakallah. I'll move to the next. Look around, where are we today? It's a very important question. God and religion forgotten, idol and human worship, wars, conflicts and killings, terror and fear, interest dealings, corruption and exploitation, injustice, oppression and no human rights, marginalization of poor and have-nots, persecution of women and the weak, nudity and obscenity, confusion and restlessness. We need Muhammad's guidance. This is so mind-boggling slide, Sister Shabano. And these are topics in themselves. And definitely we will talk about this in our long-term course. Each bullet point is a topic in itself. We will talk about it. I'm just speechless. Sister Shabano, please comment.
I just want to comment that it's very sad to see that these are all bullet points. Are we see, we are the what we can see, and we really believe that we are having all these problems. And there was a book written by some foreign writer, and he said that I can see Islam in the Muslim world, but I cannot see any Muslim in the Muslim world. And I can see Muslims in the non-Muslim society, but there is no Islam. And I just want to add, and I just want to inform here, there are no school walls in the school area. There are open cycles, bicycles, and bags in our kids' school. And there is no complaint of theft. There is nothing like that. Can we imagine that if we place our bicycle outside of our house, it will be there for even for 2 hours, it will be gone. Exceptions are always there, you know. There are still, there are few places they would be, but this is something very fearing. Where we are, where is that characteristic which we need to, we are lacking. So I think this is a mind-boggling mirror to our society, and we should be very serious. It's really a serious stuff.
It is. We will definitely discuss all these points, that how we can implement Sunnah in our lives and make our lives better. So Sister Shabano, can you read next slide for me, please?
Yeah, sure. Muhammad, an introduction. Born at Makkah, Saudi Arabia in 570 AD, trader in his 20s, recognized as trustworthy among his people. First marriage at the age of 25 to Khadija, a widow aged 40 years. Personal appearance, handsome, features, bright face, likable temperament. Captivating at distance and very sweet and most handsome from near, talk sweet and word clear. Graceful, handsome, eyes black and large, hair long and thick, voice clear, charming to look at and well built. MashaAllah, subhanAllah, Muhammad, peace be upon.
So, so he was combination of inner beauty and outer beauty. This is what slide is telling me. SubhanAllah. Yeah. SubhanAllah. And being trustworthy, he was a trader and he already earned the trust of people at the age of 25. Think 25. Of a person in 25, in 20s today. We need to have that kind of moral. SubhanAllah, it's a big lesson for the youngsters today. Okay, I'll read through and you can comment. Muhammad, an introduction. Bestowed prophethood when he began receiving revelation at 40. The first verse is, read in the name of your Lord who created men from clots of the blood. Read, your Lord is most bounteous, who has taught the use of the pen, has taught men what he did not know. Quran chapter 96, called people to the truth, faced persecution in Makkah, migrated to Medina where he was welcomed wholeheartedly. Sorry about that. Migrated to Medina where he was welcomed wholeheartedly. A new phase began where Muhammad laid the foundations of society based on divine guidance. I think there is nothing to be discussed here. Do you want to say something about the first revelation?
I think it's very clear. Just we have to focus on the first ayah which was revealed. Read. So education, whether it is knowledge, divine knowledge or worldly, it is given the most importance in the...
That's very important point. That's very important point, that education is very important, right? Whether it's by divine or whether it's man taught or it's any source. The education and the knowledge is very important. Beginning of divine revelation leads to a new era. So this is divine revelation. We will briefly talk about it. And there are different aspects. What I should say, it is addressing different areas, the revelation. Revelation was in the form of Quran, right? But the message of Allah was in the form of Quran. Now, it encompasses various areas. It encompasses all the area of human being. The Quran is guidance for all aspects of our lives. And what are those? Way of life as per divine guidance, not human desires. Long-term, not short-term. Permanent guidance and solution, not temporary. Addressing all human beings, rich and poor, black, white, educated and ignorant. Addressing all aspects of life. For the entire world, not a region or country. Guidance from the Creator who knows men unlike others. Laws and values from heaven, not earth. I think this is also self-explanatory, but Sister Shabana, would you like to add something?
I think it's almost very much clear. It's very much clear. The slide is very much beautifully explains the concept of divine revelation. As it is by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so it is a complete, perfect revelation. Yeah. So it opens all the ignorant parts of the human personality, whether any type of ignorant parts. So it is addressing all aspects of human life.
True.
And the beautiful thing is it is addressing all human beings.
True.
Not all Muslims. So right. It is for for all the humanity. This is very important.
Very important.
Yeah, ayyuhan nas.
That's beautiful concept.
Exactly.
So origin over 1400 years. Muhammad presented the guidance over 1400 years back. For all the times to come. 610 AD to 2006, it's just a timeline, now and the future. Like the best values of life we see today were given, this is a timeline of the life. So just an example. Okay. The best values of life we see today were given 1400 years ago. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, proven cure can solve all our problems and set the human world on the right course once again. Sister Shabana, would you like to add something?
Yeah, it Yeah, it indicates that from where we our ignorant part was addressed fully, you know, from 610 AD, that's the time when revelation was first just the explained was revealed to prophet peace be upon him. So from there our the true journey to towards the realization of God and true journey to a peaceful humanity started. Because before that, it was not the whole concept of Islam was not completed. It was in a gradual way coming from different prophets one by one. But at the end, through Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, it was completed.
Right.
So we are a special ummah in this sense that you are having the full package. The complete knowledge, the Sharia, which is called the conduct, the codes of conduct, religious codes of conduct, were completed by Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So there is no, we are not having any excuse that we were not aware. So this or this was not done yet. The or this process was not completed, or this message was not completed. The last prophet means the message was completed. So I think it is indicating not only the area or the time span, all but also telling us that the true and a complete journey of knowledge began at 610 AD and it's still going on.
Yeah, and the beauty of this concept is that knowledge Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, gave us is that it's for future as well. Till the universe or the earth lasts, it's the guidance till that moment. So that's the beauty of that revelation.
Exactly. MashaAllah.
Okay. Muhammad and religion. With the advent of Muhammad, peace be upon him, the notion of religion changed. Before, religion has nothing to do with practical life. Life, religion. Religion guides every aspect of life. Religion betters life. So here the betters is used as a verb, that it makes the life better in all aspects. So the thing is, this is very beautiful pictorial representation, that another religions, the religions was a separate thing. It was certain acts or notions which were separated from the practical life. Just bowing down in front of idols, doing some rituals annually, monthly or so, and that's all. But in our religion, in Islam, speaking with someone, dealing with someone with the tenderness is also ibadah. It's also part of the religion. So it's just an example that it encompasses your whole life from waking up to sleeping. It is, yeah. Everything is, you can make every breath ibadah. You can show submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you would be practicing religion with every breath. Sister Shabana, would you like to add something?
I believe you said it all. Beautifully presented in the slide and you beautifully explained it. Sister Visha, I think we should move ahead.
Would you like to read it, Sister Shabana?
Yeah, sure. Muhammad's guidance covers all walks of life, social life, human rights, relations, social life, hygiene, ethics and etiquette, knowledge and learning, politics and governance, commerce and economy, law and justice. Wow, amazing. So it's again telling us that all the area which you explained earlier, that it is covering all aspects of life. Now the whole with topic wise detail, it is given very, it is explaining itself. That there is no area which is left. Like he has covered everything with the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has covered everything. There is no, even personal life, how to spend life personally, how, everything, I think. Education, how to be a teacher, how to be a good politician, how to be a good lawyer, how to be a good trader. You know, you name it, and he will give you a full code of conduct of that character. So I believe we all know that this is true. Right. Truly, it is true. Yeah.
Right. Jazakallah. I think the slide is self-explanatory. Rest, we can, if you start discussing each topic, it can be a whole discussion in itself. So yeah, let's move to the next.
Exactly.
I would read total change our companion describes. So we are going to look Prophet peace be upon him from the eye of a companion. Jafar radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, a companion of Prophet Muhammad at the court of a Christian king in Abyssinia. Your Majesty, we were ignorant people, worshipping idols, eating carrion, oppressing neighbors, brother fighting brother, the strong dominating the weak. When amidst us was raised a man, Muhammad, whose nobility, integrity, and trustworthiness were already well known. He called us to worship God alone. He commanded us to speak the truth, to honor our promises, to be kind to our relations, to be helpful to our neighbors, to cease all forbidden acts, to abstain from bloodshed, to avoid obscenities and false witness. Subhanallah. Do you want to say something, Sister Shabano?
Yeah, it's the same way as it was earlier to explain in a slide. What was the condition? It's in the words of that Sahabi companion of Prophet ﷺ. So how they are feeling blessed and they are feeling liberated and peaceful after his presence, his true presence, after accepting Islam, after getting an idea of true way of living, way of leading life. So I believe this is clearly explaining, but if we go on detail what was at that time and how it changes to this level, it's a great and good discussion. It would be, and I think we should keep it in our mind that in our longer sessions we will discuss it separately, because we need that introspection and we need the key points how we can attain the same state again, because we truly need Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's ideology. We need his seerah's footsteps. We literally need. So for that, we need to understand the life of Sahaba, the companion of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We need to understand the life of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the wisdom, the way he led the whole humanity. So it's amazing. It would be inshallah amazing. I'm looking forward to it.
Inshallah. This is my favorite slide, Sister Shabano.
Really?
It's beautifully designed. We took it. I don't want to take its credit. We took it from very, very good website. We will mention that as well. And those people has done amazing job.
Sadka Jariya.
And did Sadka Jariya for all of us.
Amazing. MashaAllah.
Who they are gaining that reward. A glimpse. Principle of Prophet Muhammad. Preach and practice. Now, you know what preach is? Saying something to do good. And practice is like actually doing it. So in yellow, it's all about just, you know, yellow boxes says like belief. The one yellow box says belief plus right action is equal to a result. Right means right sources or right ways plus right ends is equal to success. What I perceive from this slide is, and let me continue observation. He was without a bodyguard, without a palace, without a fixed revenue. If ever any man had the right to say that he ruled by a right divine, it was Muhammad, peace be upon him. For he had all the power without instruments and without its support. He cared not for dressing for dressing of power. The simplicity of his private life was in keeping with his public life. Bosworth Smith. Now, this is some Western scholar who must have read The Life of Prophet, peace be upon him. So that's the beauty of his character, that the people who are not Muslim, if they are reading through the life, they are admitting that thing, that even though he was not a rich person, he didn't have that kind of influence on the world, but he is the only person in the universe who had, just because he had that divine guidance with him, on the base of that, he ruled the world in his time. So this is beautiful. And the above pictorial representation is what I should say, it's the graph, or what you should say, not the graph, it's equations. They are self-explanatory, that you will get good results if you, would we get good results if we just believe good? No, we have to do some actions. And we have to adopt right means and end the things in the nice way to get the success. That's what I perceive from the slide, Sister Shabanam. Sorry for not letting you speak. I explained it all.
You explained it so well. And you were so excited to see this slide. And no doubt, it's beautifully predicted. Bishwa Salman, I think it is showing the main focus on this, that no lip service cannot make a difference.
Yes.
You know?
Yes.
Lip service cannot make a difference if you're just saying it all and you're not doing anything. I just want to quote an incident. That there was a in Khilafa, there was a person who went somewhere to preach Islam, and the Umvi Khalifa, who was there to send him there, he said that I want to advise you something. And he said, what? He said, don't try to use your words to preach. Use your action. So, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I believe if you have that practice, that is the moment when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give the power to feel and the power to influence people, you know. If you're not practicing, you will not be able to influence people practically. So, being as a teacher, as a preacher, as a human being, as understanding Islam, we should focus on what we are understanding or realizing, and we should look forward to do it, not to just have an idea and randomly get away. So we should, I think this is explaining it so well, so beautifully.
Jazakallah khair for the beautiful incident, for sharing that incident. It's really beautiful. Okay. A glimpse, noble characters. There are a few slides for the glimpse, so I won't read it again. Noble character, simple yet elegant habits, no material temptations, relished tasty food, enjoyed the beauty of flowers, the fragrance, perfumes, never scolded his young servant. When seated among his followers, he would not occupy a special seat. Personal belongings at the time of his death, mattress of dried palm leaves, water skin, and an armor. 10 years, said his servant, I was with the Prophet and never said as much as fie to me. Circumstances changed, but the Prophet of the God did not. In the victory or in defeat, in the power or in adversity, in influence, affluence, or in indigence, he is the same man, disclosed the same character. Professor K.S. Ramakrishna Rao, Muhammad the Prophet. Another non-Muslim describing it. And I don't know about you, Sister Shabano, but this last bullet almost made me cry. We have gathered so much for our life. If we are going to take it to
grave. And we still want more, Bishwa Salman. We still not done.
I think...
Allah help us.
Yeah, we will definitely discuss all these characteristics in detail sometime. But I think they are self-explanatory for now. Sister Shabano, I would request you to read next slide. Let me know.
Yeah, sure.
Hold on, I think I have skipped one. Okay, there you go. Please start.
A glimpse. Generous, humble, and peacemaker. Forgave the people of the town of Taif who wounded him and chased him out of the city. Ordered kindly treatment of captives. Despite these were the very men who had inflicted insult and injuries to him. After the conquest of Makkah, he proclaimed general amnesty to the people who persecuted and tortured him and his followers. No exhibition of ruthless power, no feelings of revenge, no plunder. Victory meant humility to God. Blessings on the men of Medina. They gave us wheat, bread to eat. When there was little of it, contenting themselves with dates, a captive. Mashallah. May it was the rigid simplicity, the utter self-effacement of the Prophet, the scrupulous regard for his pledges, his intense devotion to his friends and followers, his intrepidity, his fearlessness, his absolute trust in God and in his own mission. These and not the sword carried everything before them and surmounted every obstacle. M.K. Gandhi.
Yeah. This is very difficult English. It's not this words are not simple, but we will translate into something simpler for our students and for us to understand more. But it seems that the characteristics of Prophet peace be upon him are being acknowledged by a non-Muslim again. So it's beautiful. Yeah. Jazakallah khair again. This is, can you read this part as well?
Yeah, blessings on the men of Medina. They gave us wheat bread to eat when there was little of it, contending themselves with dates, a captive. I think one of the captives have
opinion.
Spoken this and they have
testimony.
Added
this. It was a testimony.
Yeah.
Okay, mashallah. The light spreads Arabia to the world. Prophet sent envoys to the civilian centers of that time. Persia, Roman Emperor, Abyssinia, Hausa, Yemen. So these are at that moment, these were kingdoms, big kingdoms. So Prophet, peace be upon him, sent envoys so that they spread the teaching of Islam or take the message of Allah to these. This is self-explanatory. We'll move to next. Lifetime of lofty achievements. But what is lofty? Higher. Of higher purpose. Received divine revelation. Communicated to his generation. Explained the divine message. Demonstrated the theory with the practice. Trained his companions. All these actions he took and what it resulted in? Established a God-fearing, prosperous, peaceful, successful, and satisfied society. This is the outcome of all this. Now, this seems very easy, but I'm sure how every and each aspect took lots of effort. We will talk about it once we will start reading Sira in detail. Left behind a lasting guide. Observation. My choice of Muhammad to lead the list of the world's most influential persons may surprise some readers and may be questioned by others. He was the only man in history who was supremely successful on the both religious and secular level. Michael H. Hart, the 100 ranking of the most influential persons in the history. This is very famous book. And this is very famous person that Michael H. Hart recognized him and this is what he is saying. This is beautiful, subhanAllah. Shabana, would you like to say something? Or we should move?
We should move next. And this is our pride, this is a modern testimony. Modern man testimony.
Modern
man. Modern man. Because and it should enforce us to believe what we do have to believe.
Exactly. Okay. Can you read, please, Sister Shabano?
Yeah. Sure. Yeah. Remember that you will indeed meet your Lord, and that will indeed
Okay. Yeah, you are on the right slide. Yes, please carry on. Okay. The message, oh people. Okay. This is message for the people. Yeah.
Okay. Remember that you will indeed meet your Lord, and that He will indeed reckon your deeds. Beware of Satan for the safety of your religion. He has lost all hope that he will ever be able to lead you astray in big things. So beware of following him in small things. Wow. This, the best of the ways in one trodden by the prophets, the best of the action is that which is beneficent. The best guidance is that which is put into practice. The most valuable possession is contentment of heart. The best provision is that of piety. MashaAllah. If greatness of purpose, smallness of means, astounding results are the three criteria of human genies, who could dare to compare any great man in modern history with Muhammad? And the writer is, sorry, Bushra Salman,
it's L.A. Martin, historian. It's a,
wow.
Yeah. La Martin, yeah. not L.A., it's La Martin. He was historian, so it's his observation. It's beautiful. And these are few sayings of Prophet, peace be upon him. And they are topic in themselves. And they are, the purpose of this slide is like how profound his message was, his sayings were. They are so beneficial for our own soul, for our own self. And if we look at each saying, they have great wisdom in itself, right? So, yeah. So this is just a glimpse of his sayings, what he used to say, what kind of message he used to give to people. Subhanallah. I would like to move on the next slide. Equality and brotherhood. All mankind is from Adam and Eve. An Arab has no superiority over a non-Arab, nor a non-Arab has any superiority over an Arab. A white has no superiority over black, or nor a black has any superiority over a white, except by piety and good actions. O mankind, we created you from a single pair of male and female, and we made you into nations and tribes that you may know each other. Verily, the most honored of you in the sight of Allah is the most righteous of you, and Allah has full knowledge and is well acquainted with all things. Quran chapter 49. Appointed Bilal رضي الله عنه, a black and negro slave, as the first individual to the office of muezzin, called to the prayer. So this is about equality and brotherhood. Actually, we have whole lecture on this upcoming for you guys. We talked about this, and this ayah and this hadith is part of that. And basically, this slide is telling us that Prophet, peace be upon him, taught us equality and brotherhood. This is beautiful message. Sister Shabano, should I move to next slide?
It's self-explanatory.
Okay. The benefactor of women, first to accord higher status to the woman, first to grant the rights. And what kind of rights he has given to the woman? Like what he taught us. Right to live, right, social rights, inheritance, maintenance rights, ownership rights, education, legal rights, privacy and chastity, respect during menstruation days, security and protection. It was Islam that removed the bondage in which women are held from the very dawn of history and gave them a social standing and legal rights, such as were not granted to them in England till many centuries later. Lady Cabot, Pilgrimage to Mecca, is the book by another foreigner. I love these slides. They are referring to the testimonies of the Western people, secular people, which is beautiful. Sister Shabana, would you like to say something about this slide?
It's clearly very much self-explanatory, Sister Bushra. And I believe we will, inshallah, discuss these points, how it is different now and how it can still make a difference if we truly know the idea of liberating a woman, a woman's right. Right. Inshallah.
Inshallah. Can you recite, can you read through the slides?
Yeah, sure. Message for men, O brothers. It is true that you have certain rights in regard to your woman, but they also have rights over you. Remember that you have taken them as your wives only under Allah's trust and with His permission. If they abide by your right, then to them belongs the right to be fed and clothed in kindness. Do treat your women well and be kind to them, for they are your partner and committed helper. And it is your right that they do not make friends with anyone of whom you do not approve, as well as never to be unchaste.
So this is beautiful slide describing the rights of women, and there is the whole focus is on the man to take care, because it feels like that he knew that woman would be oppressed, and then there is the advice for woman as well. He has covered every area. He didn't
every
leave
area.
Any. MashaAllah. Please continue reading, Sister Shabana.
Yeah. Revert to Islam statement. It is only in the past 20 years that women in this country were able to open a bank account without their husband signing the check. Islamic women have always had those rights. If I stick to what the Quran says, it's clear to me that I will have totally equality. Jan, a British revert, comments on channel 4. MashaAllah. I started reading the Quran and it was an absolutely breathtaking. It could have been written yesterday or today. Von Ridley, BBC war correspondent after embracing Islam.
SubhanAllah. Wow. These are testimony from nowadays women, modern women.
Beautiful. Yeah, Muslim revert.
Yes.
MashaAllah.
Okay, please continue.
Yeah, Prophet's formula of success. I offer you happiness of this world and that of the next. Acknowledge. There is no God but Allah, and Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. I call you to God, the unique without any associate, and His obedience, and to follow me, for I am the messenger of Allah. People, no prophet or apostle will come after me, and no new faith will born. Adam, Noah, Abraham, Moses, Jesus, Muhammad. This is the, I think, ancestral background. Yes. It is very brief given.
Yes, I think the formula of success is to believe in oneness of God, first, most, foremost, important thing. And I think that's what the message was, Prophet's message, like other prophets. He is successor of...
I need to add that the concept of the last prophet emphasizes a responsibility that there will be no further guidance.
Yeah.
So we have to stick to the prophet's seerah.
Yes.
We don't have to keep on delaying it. We don't have to wait for another guidance. We need to be very seriously have that. This is the ultimate guidance. This is the last guidance. Guidance means a blessing. That blessing is done by Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. And now it is the time to get benefit out of that blessing. Last messenger means we have to be responsible enough. And being Ummah of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And we are the one only Ummah which is responsible of spreading the message of Prophet, peace be upon. It was nothing like that in earlier Ummah, you know. So this indicates the responsibility, not the arrogancy in our attitude, you know. This is a responsibility factor which we have to keep in our mind. We are sticking to this idea that we are the nation of prophet, last prophet, and he's the last prophet. He's the last prophet, so we are
the one who is much more responsible.
It comes with the responsibility. You know, if your teacher is saying that I'm not coming back till break, you have to take care of the class. What does it mean? It means that you are responsible for the class till that time.
Right.
So it's a big responsibility.
Jazakallah khair for adding beautiful perspective. I'll read quickly these two slides and we will just skip the activity. We are running out of time. The light spreads further. His companion disseminated his message around the world, and humanity has reaped benefits wherever and whenever Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him's guidance has been followed. Established God-fearing, just peaceful and prosperous state. More than 1 billion followers today, subhanAllah. The Muslim world has given many innovations that we take for granted in our daily life, how Islamic inventors changed the world, the independent. Human's history has never known such a complete transformation of society or a place before or since, and imagine all unbelievable wonders in just over two decades. Michael H. Hart, the 100, a ranking of the most influential person in history. So this is, again, this New Year's discussion, that how it was miraculous thing, the following of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. And we will definitely discuss this in detail, that how the light of Islam spread and what is our responsibility.
Inshallah.
Muhammad and you, Muhammad, peace be upon him, and you. You too can benefit from Muhammad, the messenger of God, to gain success in the life and the life after death. Please get to know more and change your life. These are the websites which are very helpful. This slide would be given to you. You can go to these slides and read more about Islam. And I think this is topic in itself. We will discuss some lessons derived from the Seerah in our long-term course and how we can change our lives. Right now, this was just introduction, like who Prophet was and what was his characteristics. As a class activity, we have, you have to write down at least five characteristics of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and tell how you can adopt those characteristics. Just use your own word, write any five which are part of slides or which are not part of slides. You are free to write it anyway. So that's all for today. And we would be coming with another amazing topic. Jazakallah khair for listening to us. Jazakallah, Sister Shabano. Jazakallah, amazing teachers in the class will be there again. Thank you so much. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum.